The most exciting 2 minutes in sports, 2025, the Kentucky Derby. We're with inside 18 days to the big dance, and we continue on with our handicapping discussion, giving you a chance to pick your own Kentucky Derby winner 2025. We are going to show GPS data, and again, there will be a link to a spreadsheet with the data, so you can just follow along, but we're going to show deep GPS data for distance traveled, strides, stride length, analyze some of these different horses a little bit differently than you see a lot of times. There's only so many times you can look at a buyer speed figure and have that be your only data point. So we're trying to present new data, get people to handicap, learn the process, enjoy the 2025. How efficiently they move does impact the stride and the stride length. And we'll take a look at where to get this data from Equibase GPS charts. It's the GPS Stride Length Show 2025. Already up on the channel, we've got the final fractions theory, which shows the final 3/8 and final 1/8 contenders for all of the contenders in the 2025 Derby. You can watch that video, and there is a link to a spreadsheet with that data. But GPS data, it comes from Equibase. It's only been out for a few years now. They've switched providers. We now have GMAX data. And so we don't have a lot of historical data. We're kind of building up the database the last couple of years. And with the GPS data, we don't have it for all tracks. So we currently do not have GPS data for the fairgrounds, although we do have it for Aqueduct, Gulfstream, Keeneland, Santa Anita, tracks like that. So I would imagine in the next 2-3 years, GPS and GMAX data will be available for all racetracks. But we're gonna look at a few different factors for handicapping. The distance they traveled. So even though races might be 9 furlongs, depending on post position and how they get around the track, their trip, some horses run further than other horses. And then we're gonna look at the number of strides. So again, how efficient they move. Larger horses are gonna have a longer stride, but that is not always the most efficient. Depending on the angle of that stride and the shoulder length, sometimes a faster frequency can get you there quickly. And then we're gonna look at stride length for the GPS data to kind of harrow in on some of the contenders. Now, the first thing we look at is distance traveled. You can get this from Equibase. Yeah, I highlighted a couple of points here. Number one is the total distance traveled. Number two is the second place finisher distance traveled. And then you can see from the data category, there's a drop-down box at Equibase for the distance traveled. So in the Bluegrass Stakes, Burnham Square ran 5,991 feet. He actually ran 42 feet more than East Avenue. Now, some people say a length is right around 8 feet. So even though Burnham Square only won by a head, he actually ran 42 feet or maybe 4 lengths further than East Avenue. Now, I say maybe because depending on the trip, sometimes running farther is actually better. And it depends on the pace of the race, when they run far out in the track. If they do it on the turn when everybody else is fading, it's not as impactful. If they run it in that first 1/8 of a mile, they're going a farther distance. So that's distance traveled. You can get that from Equibase. Now, other factors to look at is the total strides. Now, this is, you can see 1, 2, and 3. 1 is the data category, the number of strides. And you see number 2, 245 strides for Burnham Square. East Avenue took 250 strides. And what this is the every time you have to take a stride, that's energy. And the more energy you use early in the race, you won't have available later in the race. And then the third handicapping factor for strides is the stride length. Now, what we do here is we take the total distance traveled, we divide it by the number of strides, and that gets you your stride length. And obviously, a longer striding horse is not coming down as quickly, but we're gonna show you some examples. Sometimes taller horses are gonna have a longer stride, but that's not always the case. And then horses that have an angle of their stride, so that way they have a stride that's lower to the ground, that helps them gain power with that stride. So the lower number strides is not always better. It depends on the power and the extension they're getting out of that stride. Now, here is a factor. The longer distance a horse can travel per stride, they have fewer strides in the race. And that translates into covering the same distance with less time and energy. So that's why it may be important to have a longer stride length. Now, you do have to account for the size of the horse and the number of strides per furlong. And then as horses get tired, their strides get shorter. So we'll show you a couple of examples of that as well. Now, again, an example of this is American Pharoah and Secretariat. Secretariat had a shorter stride than American Pharoah, but he allowed himself to propel himself with more power, and he also had a larger heart. So there's other factors. We don't have all of this data. Some people do. Trust me, there's people out there with a lot of data, and that data is not publicly available. They're measuring their stride efficiency. They're measuring their stride length. They're measuring this at sales. They're measuring this at different points in the race. All we can do is look at the free data and help handicap and get some of that data. Now, again, for each race, not every race, even though a race can be 9 furlongs, some races have a longer run-up. And what the run-up is how long they travel before they start the stopwatch on the race. So the Florida Derby this year had a 130-foot run-up. The Arkansas Derby had a 60-foot run-up. The Virginia Derby, only a 38-foot run-up. Again, all of this will be in a spreadsheet that's available for download. Now, again, with that Florida Derby this year, since it was a longer run-up, they ran further before the clock started, which means we've got faster fractions for the Florida Derby this year. They went 47-1 for the half, 111-3 for 6 furlongs. So it's hard to compare year to year with these run-ups changing. So all we can do is build the database, look at the data. Again, this data is used with final fractions, pedigree information, speed figures, class handicapping, workout information. There's more details in the spreadsheet so you can follow along. Now, here's some of the results for this year. The number of, this is sorted by distance traveled. So Burnham Square ran the most distance. He ran 5,991 feet. So did Beza. Beza lost the Santa Anita Derby. Journalism ran 5,962 feet. That is 29 feet less than Beza, and that's almost 3 lengths. And then American Promise ran 5,947 feet going a 1-turn mile. Now, here it is, the data sorted by stride length. You've got Grande, 25.29. A lot of people talk about Curlin, a big long stride. Sandman has a long stride, 25 feet. American Promise, he's 17 hands, so he has a long stride. Now, I think Journalism generates a lot of power with this stride. He's quick, he's efficient, he moves very fastly, low to the ground. So for his stride, even though it's shorter, it's very efficient. So that's why you can't just take the horse with the longest stride. Now, Final Gambit, he's got a longer stride. East Avenue, a little bit of a shorter stride. Citizen Bull, a very short stride. So that's why it wasn't surprising to me that as he goes longer distances, he's probably going to get less efficient. Now, one thing I have noticed, the Into Mischief horses do tend to have a shorter stride. Now, Sovereignty does have a long stride for an Into Mischief. So we'll see how that plays out as he runs longer distances. Now, the key statistics, 24 feet is a good stride length, 5,991 feet, the most distance traveled on the Derby trail this year in the preps, and right around 262 strides for some of these horses for the max number of strides. Now, here's the number of strides. Cole Battle took the most strides, 262 strides. Citizen Bull, he took a lot of strides with that shorter stride. Tappan Street, 254 feet. I should note, now Citizen Bull was eased in that Santa Anita Derby, basically that last eighth of a mile. The jockey kind of stood up on him. So of course he's going to take more strides. So you normally want to use the number of strides in races where the horses are competitive. Once they get 4 to 5 lengths back and they're kind of eased up, the number of strides isn't as important. But it does show you the correlation between stride length and stride efficiency and the number of strides. Again, you can get all this data in the spreadsheet. Now here's an example. Cole Battle, as he ran a longer distance, his stride got shorter. In the Rebel, his stride length was 22.96, and he went down to a 22.74 in the Arkansas Derby. So in the Derby, Kentucky Derby, he's gonna go 1.25 miles. Is his stride gonna get even shorter? That's what we don't know. Now there is a correlation. I'm gonna get all of the data I can for 2-3 years. We are gonna have this available for next year's Derby, maybe even before this Derby, as I start to look at the correlation and the statistical significance of the longer distances. Sandman, another example, even his stride got shorter going a longer distance, but he starts out with a longer stride. So he's probably not gonna shorten stride as much in the Kentucky Derby. Now again, if a horse is bumped or if somebody gets in their way, it doesn't matter how long their stride is. You still have to work out a good trip. You still have to handicap the race. We've got final fractions up, dosage, the strike system, more handicapping factors coming up, including pedigree, speed figures, class analysis, pace analysis. Make sure to watch those videos. So remember, for the GPS contenders, we gather the data, we do the stride analysis, and then this helps you make your final selection for the Kentucky Derby 2025, giving you more ways to look at the data. Download the spreadsheet. It's in Google Sheets. You can do a save as. You can highlight the data. And we've got the post position show on April 26th, Kentucky Derby on the first Saturday in May. Don't forget the Kentucky Derby Pedigree Show with Jessica Tugwell live Tuesday, April 29th at 7 o'clock. You can ask your questions of national pedigree analysis, Jessica Tugwell. We've got the Triple Crown Prospectus. Sign up for more information on the Kentucky Derby and previews of all the way through the Belmont Stakes. Like, comment, share, and subscribe. If you like this video, smash that like button. That gets me more views. Support the channel if you can by giving a donation. Tip jar is in the description. The spreadsheet is in the description. And we got the final fractions theory video up, the John White strike system. How do you use GPS data in handicapping the Derby? Do you use miles per hour? Do you use other data? How do you incorporate this with your speed figures? Leave a comment. And remember, Dwayne Lucas always says, people have opinions, horses have the facts.